So is Milanote 2.0 worth it? And is it a great way to be able to collaborate and organize your team's information? In today's video, we're taking a look at Milanote. So let's dive in. So folks, let's give you a bit of an overview first off, and then let's dive into the features of Milanote 2. I guess a little bit of what's changed as well. And also, let's dive into a conclusion in who this is most recommended for and most suitable for nearer the end. As you can imagine, Milanote's been around for a little bit of time now. It is a way for people to collaborate in sort of like a board canvas style format, using lists, using images, using files to be able to visually coordinate. It's really popular with designers. Those designers, for example, at Uber, Chanel, Envision, and also Xero are all using it as a way to plan and coordinate their information. And it's becoming really popular. These sort of mural style applications like Miro has also sort of gained a bit of attention in the space. So Milanote is free. You can get 100 notes for free, as well as unlimited board shares, and also up to 10 file uploads, which is not too bad for getting started, but they do have a monthly price, which is billed annually at $9.99. If you want the monthly billing, I think it's $12.95 or something in that region. I'll make sure to include that information below. But in this new version, there is a new look. They've added dark mode. Also, apparently 100 plus templates for you to get started, so you save a bit of time necessarily organizing your information. So let's take a look at some of the features. Let's jump over and actually take a look at what Milanote 2.0 looks like. So here we are with Milanote. And for those who haven't tried it yet, this is essentially your canvas. It's very similar to applications like Miro, and there was an application called Muriel or something like that. But it is basically a canvas style application. You can drag in these notes, and naturally you can create these notes with bullet points, number checklists, as well as links and highlighters, everything else. You can drag in links as well, which help you to add in bookmarks and useful areas like that. You can add a to-do list, which allows you to start assigning and even giving due dates. So for example, I could say review Milanote. You can add a due day, so tomorrow, and even assign it to a person, in my case, myself. And you can also add lines, so you can connect up different areas. So if I drag this one in, you can see that if you had a specific, for example, you're demonstrating something, then that's something you can do. You can even bend the lines as well. Very similar to apps like Miro. And you can even add columns as well. So columns are essentially this way to start adding. They're almost like one portion of a Kanban. They're a column in a Kanban where you can start adding cards. So for example, you said you could say ideas for the new client. You can add in all of that stuff below. So that's quite a neat way in utilizing it. You can also add comments, add images, and also upload files. We'll come back to the images because that's a fairly new feature as well. But the real sort of magic is this board's ability. So you can create a new board, and for example, you could call this one work, and naturally give yourself an icon for it, and you can also lock the position. But if I went into it, this is where the new template builder comes in. So down in the bottom right hand corner, you can essentially create this project workflow, and this is essentially a Kanban board, but it does allow you to create a sort of start to finish experience. You can choose a mood board, which gets you started organizing everything visually, but there are tons of other templates and actually a range of industries. So let's go to the productivity section and let's choose the weekly planner. So this is what the weekly planner looks like, allowing you to plan some of your tasks for the upcoming week. Team planner, allowing you to see, you know, per person, what's your sort of planning together. The project workflow and the inspiration board as well. You can also choose ones for startups as well. There's a startup hub, for example, which leads to the different team members. Also, it can allow you to sort of go into different other boards. So you can have a board within a board. So using these templates is great. And what the one thing you can do is, for example, if you chose this project retrospective or this agile task board, you can click keep example content so that when you paste it in there, you can keep all the stuff there. But in this case, let's just choose the productivity week planner and press use. And it keeps it nice and clean for you. And you can naturally start adding details here. So as you can imagine, you can add a board within a board, which is all very helpful. You can even add a board within a column as well. So that's a new templates feature. The other new feature that they rave about as well is tucked away inside of account settings. So if you go over to appearance, you can see a different sort of size. So you can see the larger text if you want to, smaller text, but there's a dark mode now. And you can see there that naturally the dark mode looks a lot nicer. You've also got preferences as well, which are to do with the 3D effects when you drag stuff on the screen. So you can see there's a slight 3D effect there. So that's the new dark mode that's been added, and a lot of people are liking that one as well. So the new thing that you can do is when you right click, you can go and change the board background if you want to. So you can actually give it the board itself a different color, even though sticking in dark mode. You can choose a custom color if you wanted to. So say for Keep Productive, we wanted this nice blue. So you can actually choose your background color, which is something that a lot of people wanted in this version. So you can add an image. You can either upload your own or search through Unsplash. And the quite cool thing as well is you can now edit your image. And this is something that they've added to help people sort of save a bit of time necessarily going into other applications. So you can crop it, you can rotate it, and that naturally will help you to sort of plan stuff. So if I press save, that image is updated all within there. So you can't do mad amounts with it. You can actually still add the color and the caption, etc. But to be honest, it's a very basic editing, but something that I think a lot of designers and creatives specifically wanted to see. So if you're a designer, a creative that likes to plan and organize their information in a visual fashion, say use applications like Trello to be able to coordinate information in a Kanban board, this might be an application for you. This is sort of like having a desk, but on the screen, because you can actually move stuff into areas sort of organize it a bit like you would be your desk if you were a visual designer in terms of coordinating that information. Now, what's great about this application is it's collaborative. So if you work with other people that want to provide feedback on things you've uploaded or your process and being able to coordinate your information, that's great. And it's not just a good tool for that. It's got productivity nature. So you can actually plan your own life or plan your work life around that too in separate boards, so that it also helps you to plan and manage all of your information. Now, there is an iOS application, so you can manage on the go, and it is at a fairly reasonable price in my opinion, especially for designers. So guys, that was Milanote. Please do let me know in the comments what you guys think about it. As you can imagine, it's becoming more and more popular. These sort of like collaborative applications, as well as outliners, are getting a lot more attention in 2020. But let me know what you think. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button and also subscribe if you are brand new. It'd be great to have you. We do tons of reviews like this, giving you all you need to know about productivity apps and software. So guys, a big thank you. I will talk to you guys very soon. If you want to tweet me at @Francesco_D_ALES and share your thoughts on Milanote too. But guys, a big thank you, and I'll talk to you guys very soon. Cheerio.